Dave Staley has more on what could be a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity for the Trion players, coaches, and fans, too.
In Georgia, the battle cry is make it to the dome. Coach Mark Loudermilk's Bulldogs have reached that goal. Trion worked hard this week, getting ready for Friday morning's single-A semifinal matchup with unbeaten and top-ranked Lincoln County. Yes, I said Friday morning, 9 a.m. at the Georgia Dome. That'll throw your schedule off just a little bit.
We're going to get bed early. We're going to have quite a few lights out at 10 o'clock when we go down and spend the night. And we'll get up at 5 o'clock in the morning, so we'll be ready to go.
You know, we'll have to eat pregame at 5:30, and it won't be steak and green beans and baked potatoes. It's going to be eggs and grits and toast and cereal and that kind of stuff.
Traveling this deep into the playoffs is a dream come true for the Dogs and the Trion community. At 12-1 this season, the Bulldogs have steamrolled just about everybody. Loudermilk says he's trying to keep his kids focused, but with all of the hype, that's easier said than done.
Make sure we have a good time going down there and all that kind of good stuff. But the main thing, we can't lose our focus on why we're going down there. We're going down to play Lincoln and, you know, and try to win a ball game.
Beating Lincoln County and advancing to the state title game will be a tough task, but if any team can do it, it's Trion. The Dogs have won 3 state championships, the last coming in 1974. And that's the last time a team from our coverage area in North Georgia won it all. Who'd the Bulldogs beat in the finals that year? Lincoln County. From Trion, Dave Staley, News Channel 9 Sports.
Live from the Georgia Dome in Atlanta, Georgia, it's the Class Single-A state semifinal. The Red Devils of Lincoln County take on the Trion Bulldogs. And good morning, everybody, and welcome. I'm John Wilkerson, along with Larry Prather. This is the first of 10 football games here on GPTV, and we've got a dandy starting off. Lincoln County, undefeated and making their 5th appearance at the Georgia Dome, takes on Trion, making their first, Larry.
Rich in tradition, storied histories, both teams. The class of Class A here this morning and tomorrow morning. The Lincoln County Red Devils are going to be led by their senior quarterback, Travis Clark, 37 passing touchdowns, 4,700 yards passing just in his senior season here with the Lincoln Red Devils. Leading them on defense will be their senior linebacker, Josh Baird, 111 tackles on the season. Quite a leader.
And let's hear from Lincoln County head coach Larry Campbell.
The biggest problem we've had this year has been injuries at tailback. We've lost 4. 2 to ACLs, 1 to a broken foot, and 1 to a broken wrist. So we are playing tailbacks by committee, trying to get one healthy. And last week we lost one on Thursday. Had to take our fullback and put him back there. So we was in a 1-back offense this past week because that was the only one we had healthy. Won't get one back because all of them are serious injuries, but we have multiple set. We throw the football quite a bit, and we also run the option. Defense is the same old thing, 50, just a regular 50 defense, same thing we've been doing for the last 3 years. So nothing exciting or different on the defensive side of football.
Now let's tell you about the Trion Bulldogs. Larry, a team that has a reputation of being fast, but they're a lot faster than you think.
The coaches say that they look fast on film. They're even faster in person. From Northeast Georgia, the Trion Bulldogs, led by their senior running backs, Chris Chapman, number 5, 1,100 yards, 17 touchdowns on the season. And in the backfield with him, Daniel Blevins, number 22, senior running back as well, 953 yards, 17 touchdowns as well. 2 great
And let's hear from Trion head coach Mark Loudermilk.
You know, offensively, we're a wing option type team. You know, hopefully we can get the triple option going, the inside veer and the outside veer going, maybe a little quick pitch on them on the edges, and then come back with a counter tray a little bit, and then hopefully get all that going good. Maybe a little play action here and there, kind of mix it up, keep them off balance a little bit. And then defensively, we play a 50, and hopefully we angle one side or slant and kind of control the line of scrimmage maybe a little bit and won't be so predictable where we're going to line up at and everything. And we play kind of like a cover 3 back there and just try and put a little pressure on the quarterback and try not to get them on the edge or anything.
Now let's hear from the third member of our crew down the field, Gerald Oliveri. Good morning, Gerald.
Good morning. Thanks, guys. You talked about Daniel Blevins, and he'll be playing for Trion today. And his grandfather, Clarence Blevins, was actually the head coach for Trion in 1974 when they won the Class A state championship. Well, they beat the Lincoln Red Devils in that matchup. Well, the ironic part about it was the head coach for Lincoln was legendary coach Larry Campbell. This sounds like it should be a classic, guys. Back up to you, John.
Thank you, Gerald. So there's some history between these two teams, and we'll get set to kick it off. Lincoln County and Trion. We're back here on GPTV after this. Back to the Georgia Dome, John Wilkerson, Larry Prather, and Gerald Oliveri joining you for this Class Single A state semifinal. You know, this is a 9 a.m. kickoff, and Larry Campbell's been doing this already four times. Let's hear from him.
We've done it one other time, and I do not like to stay anywhere tonight before the game, but you have to. So we're going to come in and get them up early and give them a biscuit and bring them on up. I'm a Dome fanatic. I think this is the greatest thing for high school football. So, yeah, if they tell us to play at 7 o'clock in the morning, we'll adapt to whatever it takes to be able to be here. We're just happy to be here.
Well, Larry Campbell sounds like he likes to sleep in his own bed.
He's done this 34 years. So he knows what he's doing.
Here's Lincoln County, and they've amassed several yards there, Larry.
They're an offensive juggernaut. They're number two in the state, Class A, in scoring offense. But what makes them so powerful is they're number two in scoring defense as well. They're a fine offensive and defensive machine.
And look at Larry Campbell there. Winning 34 seasons at Lincoln County and the Trion Bulldogs. And this is a team that likes to run the old triple option wishbone.
Coach Loudermilk has his wife on the sidelines. 3,300 yards rushing. It's amazing. 52 touchdowns. Not many passing yards, but they don't have to pass.
And they've got three outstanding running backs. Daniel Blevins, Chris Chapman. Actually, two. Yeah.
They're an offensive juggernaut in their own right. There is triple poison between their quarterback and the other running back, Dave.
Well, Trion has won the toss and will receive. They want the ball first. Back deep. It's Chapman and Corey Barnes.
Day has one kickoff return to his credit for a touchdown, 86 yards. So let's see if we can open up with some offensive fireworks right off the bat.
Josh Beard will kick it off for the Red Devils. And Larry, this is a game I'm really looking forward to. There's some history between these two schools. They haven't met in 29 years. 29 years, and they're going to get after it here at the Georgia Dome.
Like Gerald was saying, they have played one other time in 1974 state championship. Larry Campbell's first year playing for state championship. Trion won 7-0 on a pass with a minute 14 to go. So a little revenge for Coach Campbell.
We're underway. And it's Corey Barnes taking it at the 10. Takes a big hit and is down at the 17-yard line. Wrestled down by Antonio Searles. And so Trion will be on offense first as you take a look at Brandon Hennon, the quarterback. And he is the boss on the field, Larry. He's mainly a triple option quarterback. He's got to make the right reads, and he does, looking at his stats. Not a big-time passer, but he gets the job done. First and 10 out of Broken Bone, and Lincoln County comes out a 4-3-D, and they give it to Chapman on a sweep, but he's met at the line of scrimmage and driven back all the way to the 20-yard line. Brought down by Stephen Brown and a host of other Lincoln County Red Devils, and this Red Devil team is fired up.
Lincoln County has a great defense. They've been running a 50 all season.
Here's a Trion offense. Offensive line, it's a patchwork offensive line. Their center, Zach Lively, was a starting fullback last year and had to move to center because of injury. Day and Blevins will be the two backs that we'll tell you about throughout the day. And Chapman as well. Second down and 12 after a two-yard loss. Hennon gives it to his fullback. And he'll get a few yards. Alex Weidman on the tackle. That was Corey Barnes on the carry. Here's Lincoln County's defense. It came out in a 4-3. We'll be saying Jairus Wynn's name a lot. He's a good one along with Weidman. The linebacking core, Josh Beard, we talked about at the open of the show. He's a good one there. He's already made his presence known. The secondary, well, Chris Kreit is one to watch as well as Cumming. Third down and 9. And on the keeper, it's Hennon on the option, and he'll be brought down just short of the 30-yard line. That was Beard on the tackle, along with Octavius Andrews. Short of the first down, and so it looked appears to be three and out for Trion on their first offensive possession.
And this will be the 21st punt of the season for Trion. Their offense is so good that they don't have to punt very often. Their 21st punt for the whole season. See Bobby Dover, 160-pound freshman, masculine.
And the snap's over his head. And he'll just run it in the end zone for the safety. And it's already 2-0 Lincoln County. So Trion gets their first major mistake out of the way, right out with their first special team play.
You're always worried about Domitis. Smart play from this freshman.
Yeah, just picks it up and runs it in the end zone.
Problem is they've got to kick the football, free kick, back to the Lincoln County Devils. So they'll be on offense in great field position.
Well, this is not what Coach Loudermilk needed. I mean, he told me the other day that, you know, we've got to play mistake-free because this Lincoln County team can make you pay for your mistakes.
Coach Campbell's done this so long, he knows he can smell fear. He can smell Domitis and look for him to go for a knockout punch right off the bat as soon as they get the football. Free kick from the 20. See if Trion elects to kick off or to punt it. Looks like they're going to kick off.
They will.
And I'm going to let you tell us his name.
There's Mark Loudermilk. 21-4 in his second year at Trion. And he's done a good job. As you take a look at who's kicking off.
Yubani
Mejia.
225-pound kicker.
And back deep for Lincoln County. And the kick goes to number 12. That's Tavares Stokes. And Stokes gets to the 35, and he's brought down there by Trion's number 27, Josh Hampton. Travis Clark, and he's a dandy. Transferred in from Evans last year, and he has made his presence known for Lincoln County. 1,500 yards passing, 14 touchdowns. He's the he runs the show for the Lincoln County offense. And it's interesting to see because there's been so many injury problems with this Lincoln County team. See what they run off with on the first series. And they started in the I formation, first and 10 from the 35, and they'll give it to the first back, Octavius Andrews, and Andrews maybe gets a couple of yards, and that's it. Lincoln County's offensive line, they're big. They're athletic, and Alex Weidman is the biggest at 260. And we mentioned about the injury problems. Andrews and Jennings are your running backs, but they've gone through three tailbacks, one out for the year, others not dressed up. One back offense now as Travis Clark under center. Quick throw to Kreit. He has it, but his knee was down at the 34-yard line. It's not like the pros. You can't put the knee down and run. On the coverage was Zach Allgood. Let's tell you about the Trion defense. And this is a defense that's pretty good. Micah Lively, he's a name we'll be talking about. He's the captain of that defense. Blevins and Zach Lively, Micah's younger brother, are the linebacking crew. They run a 5-2. Allgood, Chandler, Hampton, and Barnes are your secondary. down and 11 for Lincoln County. Out of the I formation. And the give is to number 25, Joaquino Mickens. And Mickens gets about 4 yards, and that's it. And Lincoln County will have to punt.
John, as soon as we said we had the two most explosive offenses in high school football in Georgia, here they come out in this defense all the way. It's just poetic justice.
Travis Clark will also serve as the punter on this team. Zach Allgood back deep for Trion.
This is his 10th punt of the season. They've only punted 9 times this season.
And Clark kicks it. Nice punt. Allgood, he'll take it at the 25, across the 30, 35, into the 37-yard line, brought down by Josh Beard. Well, how does Mark Loudermilk feel about playing at 9 a.m.?
The good thing about us, we've been getting up lifting weights early all year at about 6:45. So we have to probably get up now a little bit hour and a half, a little bit earlier. But, pregame-wise, I've been trying to figure out that kind of thing. We'll probably eat a chicken biscuit or something like that, a cup on a Powerade, and I don't think it's going to matter that much. I think the kids will be so psyched, so pumped, playing at 9 o'clock, playing in the dome anyway. You know, the big thing is to get them to calm down, not be so excited.
And the give is to Corey Day, and he gets a few yards. Well, I think some of that excitement, Larry, left with that punt went over the punter's head.
Little excited, just a little excited. Little adrenaline, testosterone a little high here. They're full back, belly, calm it down. Coach Loudermilk's been in it long enough to know you calm it down and let the kids get their feet under them, catch your breath.
4 yard gain, and it's second down and 6. In the formation, reminds me of the old Ken Hatfield flex bone. And the give is to Blevins. Blevins has an opening just short of midfield. Brought down by Stephen Brown. And a first down for Trion, their first of the game.
And you see what has made these guys the region champs out of Northeast Georgia. See Blevins' vision. Great vision, quickness, 4-4 speed. 953 yards, 17 touchdowns on the season.
Coach Loudermilk said that Blevins has the greatest vision of any back he's ever coached, and you saw it right there. Just patient enough to let the hole open up, and boy, he blasted right through. First and 10 from 49. And on the keeper is Hennon, and he's thrown down for a loss. The Lincoln County defense fired up, drum long, throws him down.
Here you see the replay, John. Option, and Lincoln County has seen that before. They cover it well. This 4-3 is giving Trion a little bit of trouble.
And that's a new wrinkle that Coach Campbell put in. Defend that option offense that Trion runs so well.
Coach Campbell's known for tricks and wrinkles, and you know, he's going to make you coach during the game.
Second down and 11. Blevins again, and Josh Beard brings him down after a 3-yard pickup.
This is the Georgia Southern wing bone, the ham bone, back when Tracy Ham was there, that they made famous with some, you know, a little bit of alterations out of the wing tee. And from Air Force and Wofford and Georgia Southern, they have come up with a great offense to highlight the talent that they have in the backfield with all this speed.
Third and 8. Under center, Brandon Hennon. That's Blevins in motion. And we got a whistle. Thank you. First penalty in the game.
Chris Chapman just a little quick off the ball. He's going to go against the Trion Bulldogs. He'll back them up 5.
Offsides against Trion.
Trion doesn't like to throw the football. They don't be forced into a passing situation where you might get a big play off a blitz. They run it most often on third down, but they can pass the ball real effectively. They'll lull you to sleep, and then all of a sudden play action or sprint out pass, and you're in big-time trouble.
Dead ball foul, offside, offense, 5-yard penalty for the previous spot. Repeat, third down.
Tom Branch, your referee. First time we've heard from him today. As Trion is backed up, now it'll be a third and 13. As you look at a list of officials, all from the Middle Georgia Football Officials Association. On third down, Hennon with the first pass of the game, and it's incomplete, intended for Corey Barnes.
Corey read stop and go, and Hennon read the out. So a little miscommunication, still a little nervous here early in the ball game. They'll settle down, they'll get out of it. And here, let's watch for this snap and see if we can get this punt off.
Buddy Dover back deep. Corey Barnes is a long snapper for Trion, and I'm sure he's been told, son, just aim for the target. This one is low, but handled well, and it's a good kick, and it drives the Lincoln County receiver all the way back to the 10. And he's trying to make something out of nothing, and he just might down. Tavares Stokes fielded the punt for Lincoln County.
Great teams.
Six-yard pickup, but there's a flag.
John, great teams have great defenses, but they also have great special teams. And so far, we have seen some great special teams play, even though there was the one safety. But this is going to back the Red Devils up. It was a block in the back. It'll back them up half the distance. Going to be coming out of a hole.
Let's hear for our official. Well, give us the official word.
Block in the back on the receiving team, half the distance to the goal, first down.
Mark your calendar for Friday night, January 30th, for the return of Georgia's longest running high school sports and academics program, Prep Sports Plus. You'll meet some of Georgia's most successful student athletes, athletic programs, and much more. That's Prep Sports Plus, returning Friday, January 30th at 11 p.m. exclusively on GP TV. So Lincoln County's in a hole, first and 10. They're at their own 7. And the give is to Octavius Andrews. He'll get across the 10, and that's it. And the Trion defense stiffening there. If you take a look at Octavius Andrews, and he's one of the many running backs that Larry Campbell's had to use this year.
Running back by committee, tailback by committee. Octavius started the season at fullback. Now he is the back.
And so many injuries at the tailback position for Lincoln County. We'll run down later as Clark goes back to throw his first pass of the game. Flushed out of the pocket. He's going to keep it. And is nailed at the 11-yard line. Zach Rosser, Jason Brooks, and Micah Lively all there.
You can see the vision and the leadership mobility. And Travis Clark, they list him at 6 foot tall, about 215 pounds. Excellent decision to keep the ball down and not try to force it down here in his own shadows of the end zone. You see the hat on Larry Campbell. We'll get back to that later, John.
Yeah, there's a special story behind that hat. Third and 7, one back. And Clark will keep it across the 15 and 20. He's got the first down. And will be knocked down at the 30-yard line. Good call by Travis Clark as numbers Corey Barnes and Brandon Espy there on the tackle for Trion, but it's a first down for Lincoln County.
Here you see the option read, excellent read, keeper. Clark's got 460 yards rushing on the season, and what's impressive, it's six yards a carry, 11 touchdowns. Quite a runner for a quarterback.
Well, he can do it all as you take a look at his rushing numbers. 11 touchdowns on the ground. He's been a dandy for Larry Campbell's team. Out of the I formation, first down and 10. And they'll give it
double pass.
Number one, and he's going to throw it. Wide open. Stephen Brown. 70 yards. Touchdown. Antonio Searles with the throw, Stephen Brown with the catch. And Antonio Searles, Larry, was hurt, and he's just back.
They weren't sure if they were going to play him or not. But here we go, replay, halfback pass. Big games. Coach Campbell always comes up with some big plays on offense. Halfback pass out of his own end zone. What a call. That's a hard catch.
Josh Beard will kick the extra point.
When you're that wide open and that ball hangs in the air that long, it's a tough catch. Did a great job of relaxing and catching it. No domitis from these Red Devils.
They've been here before. And the extra point is good. So, 9-0 Lincoln County has four plays, 92 yards, and Brown's 70-yard touchdown reception gives us our score of 9-0. Well, what did Larry Campbell say? He had like 12 tricks up his sleeve, and I believe he just showed us one of them.
That's just one. He's got a bunch more. And he, talking to the other coaches, Coach Hardeman, he said it always surprises the assistant coaches that in every game, every big game, when the situation is tense, Coach Campbell always comes up with the right call. The winningest coach in the state of Georgia, 364 victories. What's amazing to me is his record in playoffs. He's got 88 victories in playoff games. That's more games than a lot of coaches win in their lifetime. There's Coach Campbell.
There's an interesting story about the hat he's wearing, Larry.
His boyhood friend and teammate grew up with him, Dennis Botts, head coach at Abbeville, South Carolina. High school, played for state championship a couple weeks ago. He died, had a stroke and died. And Coach Campbell will be a pallbearer tomorrow, funeral at 2 o'clock. And he was real distraught that, ought to be the happiest time of the season for him in the playoff seasons. And friend dies of a stroke, and he was really, really distraught. And he said he'd wear this hat from Abbeville, his hometown school, in honor of Coach Dennis Botts.
Beard kicks it off. And it's a short kick, and a fair catch will be made by C.B. Chandler. And Trion will take over. Down 9-0 already in the first quarter. And this is a team that runs the ball. It's not too late for them to abandon that and go pass. They'll do it.
They got here. The run brought them to the dance, and they're going to stick with it and get things going. They're calming down. Things are getting better. Coach Loudermilk, you see here, he's calm, collected, even though he's got walking pneumonia. You can see his little green around the gills.
First down and 10. From the 22. And the pitch goes to Chapman. He's down alley there. Breaks a tackle. Gets to the 35. First down. Tavares Stokes on the tackle for Lincoln County. But that's a good way to start this offensive drive for Trion.
The mark of a championship team is how they answer the bell. Chapman is listed at 170 pounds, but he gets down low. He runs under his shoulder pads, and you can see that leg strength and a little face mask in there, inadvertent face mask. Right at the end. Great camera work.
Mark Loudermilk calls Chapman my speed guy. He's the fastest guy I got on the team. 1,100 yards, Larry, 17 touchdowns. He's been a good one for the Bulldogs.
And they say he runs a 4-4, but his game speed may be a little faster than that even. He is a weapon.
And they'll walk off the face mask.
Incidental face mask on the defense. It's a 5-yard penalty from the end of the run. It's first down.
So first down for Trion at the 41-yard line. Back, and he gets the handoff, and he'll get to the 45, perhaps the 46-yard line, brought down by a host of Lincoln County Red Devils.
He'll split inside. Bailey isolating on that linebacker over there and just settling them down. Just start hitting that. When things start going wrong, you hit the guy in front of you in the mouth, and that'll help the situation. When things go bad, just hit the guy in front of you. Trion is doing an excellent job. Coach Loudermilk's play calling. Coach Hatcher, the offensive coordinator, making some great play calls.
Landed him under center. That's Blevins in motion. Gives it the fullback again. Corey Day. This time he's met solidly by Josh Beard. Maybe a couple of yards.
Day's got 13 touchdowns from the fullback position. You see KP, Kevin Patton pulling, leading on that play. This offensive line for Trion averages 213 pounds. So they match up pretty good against this Lincoln County defense, which averages around 227.
Corey Day is not afraid of contact, is what Coach Loudermilk told me. He just proved it right there. He took a nice pop from Beard. Third and three. Chapman on the sweep. Across the midfield. He'll get the first down. Just short of the 45 to about the 46-yard line. Alex Weidman on the tackle along with Lance Brooker.
Talking to Coach Ellis, defense coordinator for the Red Devils. And how do you stop a running attack like this when they've got so many weapons running the football? They're spread out horizontally. You know, you're talking about putting nine in a box. They'll get outside. They're so fast. So they're spread out sideline to sideline with their 11 players. So the passing attack doesn't make them get vertical and get deep, but they're spread out horizontally.
First and 10. Chapman in motion. They give it to Blevins, and Blevins on the counter. Maybe a yard, and that's it. Octavius Andrews was there, along with Jarris Wynn.
They're using their counter series, counter traps, the counter tray, and then the belly, and then occasionally they've mixed in the quick pitch. And look for more of the veer, more of the power, more of the isolation, running right at this really quick Lincoln County defense.
Second down and nine after the one-yard gain by Blevins. And it'll be Day bullying his way just short of the 40. About a three-yard pickup. Looks like Jarris Wynn was in on the tackle along with Alex Weidman. Well, to try and get here, the Bulldogs. Well, Johnson County shut out Jefferson and defeated Dooley County 51-36. Dooley County was here last year. That was a shootout, which Trion won on their home field.
They average 39 points a game.
Third down and five. And we have a stop of play. Well, it's the end of the quarter. That would be why we're stopping. All right. Well, after one quarter of play, it's Lincoln County 9, Trion nothing. We're back on GPTV for the second quarter after this. And welcome back to the Georgia Dome. John Wilkerson, Larry Prather, Jared Oliveri. 9-0 Lincoln County. Let's go down to Gerald.
Right now we're here with Clarence Blevins, former head coach of Trion. How did it feel to have the field renamed after you during the playoffs this year?
Oh, man, that's something else. You know, it kind of makes your heart pitter-pat. Probably not a bigger honor to an old coach than that.
Talk about your grandson for a second.
Oh, hey, there's nothing like watching your grandson play. And I've enjoyed that. You know, I had two grandsons, one graduated last year and one's playing now. Ooh, that's awesome.
All right, back to the game.
Trion High School, certainly a big football area.
Yeah. All right, back to the game.
That's great. Of course, Clarence Blevins was the coach when Trion won the state championship in 1974, defeated this Lincoln County team 7-0. That was many years ago, and Hennon is thrown down for a loss. Drum long. Blast in there and throws down Brandon Hennon. Brings up fourth and long.
6'2", 210, six sacks on the season, gives him seven tackles, 19 tackles for loss, gives him 20 tackles for loss on the season. Quite a leader. Drum long. I wonder if that's coming from Meldrum.
Bobby Dover for his third punt of the game. Good snap, good kick. And he'll bounce at the 10 and he'll go all the way to the end zone. And so Lincoln County will take over at 20-yard line. Well, what kind of bag of trick do you think we'll see in this position, Larry?
Well, he's ahead 9-0. He's got a big advantage. even though it's still early in the ball game. I really look for him to come out and do some basic things and just start getting his offense into a rhythm and setting up a special play, a trick play later on.
Somebody in the stands already reading up on the activity today here at the Dome, probably catching up on his reading about Trion and Lincoln County.
Great town, Trion, Georgia, halfway between Rome and Chattanooga.
So Lincoln County will take over at the 20-yard line to begin the second quarter. And the give is Octavius Andrews, and Andrews has an opening. And he shakes a tackle, still going, down to the 49-yard line before Jason Brooks brings him down, and Lincoln County's beginning to roll, Larry.
Trout, just basic old 32 Trout. I wonder if he, when he was growing up, if he watched a guy named Garrison Hurst, Doobie, that's a two-time NFL comeback player of the year from Lincoln County. Coach Larry Campbell was an expert on the wishbone. When he got Garrison Hurst, he went to the I formation.
It was a 27-yard pickup by Andrews. First down and 10. Fumble the ball by C.J. Norman. He's in trouble. They go over the 50-yard line to the 49. Zach Allgood on the tackle. So, in a way, C.J. Norman makes up for it as he couldn't handle a snap from Travis Clark.
See him a little bit of domitis. Looking before he tucked the football in, but you can see what speed does for you. Made a major mistake and then made up for it using that great speed.
When I talked to Coach Loudermilk on Wednesday, he said our defense does need to get in the backfield, if all possible, to cut down some of the speed of Lincoln County. And Lincoln County has been able to stretch out some long runs. As Andrews gets the handoff, and this time he is met at the line of scrimmage and thrown down for a loss. Brooks and Blevins in on the tackle.
That same trap, read it well. Smart, heady kids on defense for these Trion Bulldogs.
It's a defense that'll get after you, and they've done that today.
Well, the only blemish on this record for Trion has been their defense. They have given up 17 points per game.
And we have a timeout by Lincoln County. Take a look at Larry Campbell. 9 state championships as Lincoln County head coach. That's a feat among itself, as long as being Georgia's all-time winningest coach.
He's been here before. After he lost that state championship in 74, he reeled off 9 more state championships.
Well, tonight's game can also be viewed live on the GPTV internet site at www.gpb.org. Just follow the links to connect to the game. All of the games from the Dome this weekend will be archived and available on the GPB website as well. That's www.gpb.org. And enjoy the action at home on your PC. 9-0 Lincoln County. We've just begun the second period here at the Georgia Dome. Lincoln County taking over at the Trion 49-yard line. That is safety and a touchdown pass by Antonio Cerros to Stephen Brown. That's been the only scoring so far. Clark with a quick throw. Incomplete. Yes, it was a forward pass. Ronci Cummings was the intended receiver.
Coach Campbell's upset. He had it set up. He's the master of play calling. He had a crack back block. If he could have caught that pass, he had a lot of room, a lot of green artificial grass down the sideline.
I tell you, Larry, that was walking the tightrope between lateral and forward paths.
Yeah, everybody was going for it.
That'll bring up 4th and 7 for Lincoln County, and Travis Clark will punt.
There's Ronci Cummings on the reception, the drop, captain for the team.
Zach Allgood back deep. And we got a flag.
And I think they're going to call offsides on Trion, and this is going to bring up an interesting situation. See if Coach Campbell wants to roll the dice on 4th down and about 2 yards.
See if he can try to keep it. They're calling it on the red devil.
Lincoln County. Okay.
Eliminates that decision. Little
well,
movement.
None of these teams want to have mental mistakes like that in a big game like this, as we hear from our referee. Well, maybe not. Santa Claus is at the Georgia Dome. And he looks to be a Trion Bulldog fan.
Christmas has already come early for a couple of football teams right here. 26-yard average for Travis Clark on his punting on the season.
It's a good snap, an excellent kick, and all good. We'll let it roll. And that's going to roll a long way and be down inside the five.
It hit a Lincoln County coverage guy on the knee right at the 20, and they do. They have it spotted at the 21. The officials correctly spotted that. And where they touch it, that's where the Bulldogs will get the football.
So that's where Trion will take over. And Larry, they've been getting excellent yards per carry by their running backs, but I guess the bend but don't break philosophy by Lincoln County has been taking over.
I think it's a little bit of the domitis for the Trion Bulldogs, Coach Loudermilk. I think they're just, you know, playing it close to the vest.
First touching on the kicking team, the ball is placed at the 21-yard line. First down.
There you see
that's
Coach
Loudermilk. That's a break for Coach Loudermilk and Trion.
Big break.
Instead of having it at the 1, you get at the 21. First and 10 at the 21. Corey Day alone back. And he'll get the handoff, and he'll get to the line of scrimmage, and that's it. Alex Weidman was there to wrestle him down.
Big Alex, 6'4", 6'2", 240-pound junior. He'll be a major college prospect next year. Oh, yeah, you see that leg strength.
And Corey Day never had a chance. Lucky to get back to the line of scrimmage.
Alex is tough. 83 tackles on the season coming in.
Second down and 9 as they give him a 1 yard gain, forward progress to the 22. That's Blevins in motion. He'll get the pitch. Has a little alley, breaks the tackle, gets it short of the 30-yard line. Tavares Stokes and Ronzi Cummings there.
Great balance, great balance. Going back to his grandfather Clarence, first football game I ever coached in high school was against Trion, Coach Blevins.
You?
Yes, first year I was a young green assist coach. I cannot remember. I've been racking my brain. It was 7-0. I remember that. One touchdown his first game of the season. Coach Blevins, 2 years later, went on to win his state championship in 74. Great guy, great coach.
Third down and 2. All good. The lone receiver. And he'll give it to the fullback. And he has met the line of scrimmage. Octavius Andrews there stops Corey Day. And he'll bring up fourth down.
Octavius, they call him Tay, middle linebacker. He's starting running back, starting fullback, and starting middle linebacker. Runs a 4.6 40. 195-pound senior.
On fourth and 1, Trion's going for it.
Freeze play, John. See if I can draw my sides. Wishbone look.
And Hennon drops back in the shotgun. And he'll call timeout and couldn't draw him offside.
Why not?
You got nothing to lose when you come to the Georgia Dome. Mark Loudermilk in his second year fighting pneumonia.
His wife is the certified athletic trainer for the team, Julie. His son, Mac, is on sidelines water boy, so I'm sure they're keeping an eye on him, trying to keep him hydrated and keep him safe. His first time that he has been to the Georgia Dome, even though he coached Thomasville and Peach County. Still got a great tradition.
Georgia Public Broadcasting has made it easier than ever to show your support for great local programs like our coverage of the GHSA football playoffs. Simply visit our website at www.gpb.org. It's totally secure, simple to use, and takes just 2 minutes. And thank you for your support of Georgia Public Broadcasting. Well, Looks like Coach Loudermilk is trying to make a decision whether he's going to punt it or go for it. Because,
well, he's used a timeout, and that's crucial. Every timeout that you use, you want to make it pay off. And
Hennon is still in there, and he's going to call the play in the huddle. And Trion's going to go for it.
Major, major gamble here.
Give it to Chapman. He'll get the first down, get to the 40, and tackle up the sideline to the 41-yard line. What a call.
Dwayne Hatcher, Coach Hatcher, offensive coordinator. Great job, Coach. They made that timeout pay off.
Boy, that was a gutsy call. Second quarter, and you go for a first down.
You know, the VCRs around Georgia are running today. Parents, grandparents, uncles and aunts taping this game for the lifetime of memories.
There's Chapman's numbers. He's a speed back of this three-back wishbone system, triple option of Trion. And Hennon's going to throw. And he's looking deep, and he's looking toward Auger.
Oh!
Almost the catch. That was Chris Chapman.
Put it over the wrong shoulder. Chapman made a great adjustment to come back on it, and it was right in his hands. But what a play call. Just, got a little momentum, got a big change in momentum here and now. Let's see if we can put him away. Excellent play calling. Good game plan.
Well,
right
that
in
was
his hand. Had to lay
right
out.
On his fingertips. Oh, yeah. Couldn't haul it in. Ronson Cummings was beat on that play.
Coach Campbell from Lincoln County predicted it'd be low scoring. Both teams averaging right at 40 points a game. And he predicted it'd be low scoring, and true to form.
Second and 10.
You don't get out there that quick,
though. Give it to Barnes. I'm sorry, Corey Day. And he'll get a few yards. Alex Weidman on the stop. Looks like to me Trion was trying to loosen up things in the Lincoln County defense.
You know, the last two times they've tried that fullback midline play, it's just been hammered. Got about 3-4 yards on it that time, so it is, John, it is working. Starting to loosen it up a little bit. They've got to get horizontal with this Lincoln County defense. Got to eliminate some of that speed.
3rd and 6. Corey Day, I should say. The lone fullback. Levin's in motion. Hennon rushed, and it's picked off. Picked off by Antonio Searles. Touchdown, Lincoln County, 38 yards. And they're loving it in Red Devil Country. The fans from Lincolnton.
Here you go. You see the replay, Johnny. He's under pressure, throwing it under duress. I don't think that he ever saw him.
Tried to get the Chapman, and Searles had it. An easy touchdown.
The big 58 is Jarvis Wynn, sophomore. 6'4", 245 pounds, sophomore.
Josh Beard will attempt his second PAT. And he does. 16-0, Lincoln County over Trion. Antonio Searles, well, he's thrown a touchdown pass. He's picked one off. And here's a guy that had his hand slammed in a car door.
Here we go, John. Another look at it. A toss back screen. It was a great play call, but it just under duress. If he could have had his eye, got a vision, hadn't had someone in his face, been a lot different. His vision's blocked. He never saw it.
Antonio Searles had his car slammed on his hand by his sister recently. He's just back, and he's made a huge impact on this game. As Lincoln County has taken a 16-0 lead, and Josh Beard will kick it off for the Red Devils. Barnes and Chapman are back deep.
Talking about a championship team answering the bell, John. This next series is going to be pretty much crucial for the Trion. Here we go, John. Lincoln County Red Devils, fourth team in the state to have 600 victories with last week's win over Metter. The coach
Coach Campbell there, youngest coach in the nation to win his 600th game.
It's a short kick taken by Corey Day. I'm sorry, Corey Barnes. Too many Coreys on the Trion team. He'll get it out to the 31-yard line. It's an amazing accomplishment when you have a program that can win 600 football games and only four teams in the state have done it.
Valdosta with 800 leads the nation. Then you got Thomasville and LaGrange, which made it this year, and then Lincoln County, fourth in the state to hit the 600 mark. It's an amazing program. Both teams, Trion's got a great program as well. Lincoln County is number two in the state behind Valdosta in number of state championship wins.
On first down, it's Chapman on the sweep. He cuts, maybe gets a few yards. Jarvis Wynn there to stop him. And he'll pick up about 4 yards.
Lincoln County has just not done anything, made any mistakes to help the Bulldogs out. They've got to depend on the Red Devils to do something to give them a little help to get back into this football game. 6 minutes to go here in the quarter, John. This offense has got to get cranked up and help their defense out. They're not used to playing defense like this.
Down, six. And it's Chapman again. This time he's wrestled down, drum long. May have got back to the line of scrimmage. They'll bring up third down and long.
Counter, they're trying to go off tackle. You see a big split there between the guard and tackle. They're trying to get off tackle with it, and he had to bounce outside. This Red Devil defense, the defensive lines were crucial coming into the game. Both coaches talked about their defensive lines having to control the line of scrimmage.
Coming up after this one, Vidalia and Charlton County in the 2A semifinal. Washington County and LaGrange battle in the 3A semifinal. A rematch between Thomas County Central and Marist in the 4A and Camden County and Noonan in the 5A. On third down, it's Blevins, and Blevins stops short of the 40-yard line. He'll be about a yard short of the first down. He's brought down by Dante Parks and Josh Beard.
And they're not sending Corey Day, Coach Day, into the football game. He's their long snapper. And I think they're going to go for it on fourth down, John.
Well, they gambled and won last time.
Similar place on the football field. They'll be on their own 40-yard line, and they're going for it, John. Unbalanced formation. Power left. Power to our side here.
All good. The lone receiver to the left is Kyle Abernathy, the tight end in motion. They give it to Blevins, and Blevins will get the first down and just short of midfield to about the 48-yard line. Alex Weidman brought him down. So two fourth down possessions have been successful, Larry.
They're having a little success with the toss, sweep, speed sweep. And that cut right there, amazing. He's 4-4-40, and he made his cut at 90-degree angle at about 4-4 also. Great move. Get that little couple extra yards. 15 seniors, they're very, very, very savvy. Know what they're doing.
First and 10. We'll try and pull them. Ready in motion. Hennon will throw. Being harassed. Can't get away. Loses the football. It appears Trion got it back. Daniel Blevins falling on it. But it's going to be a loss of about, looks like 3 yards, as Hennon just had no chance.
They've only thrown 51 passes in the whole season, so they don't like to throw football, but they can. They can be very effective.
Alex Weidman was there to strip him of the football. Daniel Blevins was there to keep possession of the football with the Trion Bulldogs. Second and 13. Two receivers on the left side. Pitch goes to Chapman. Chapman can't get away. Maybe gets a couple of yards. Lancey Cummings there on the tackle. Assisting him was Octavius Andrews.
Cummings, number 27 here.
captain for this week. He had two interceptions last week against Metter. They made him the captain for this game. You see his speed.
Well, here's the final four in Class Single A. Right now it's 16-0 Trion. We have a rematch tomorrow. Clinch County and Hawkinsville. They met last year in the state semifinals with Clinch County winning. They'll play it again here at the Georgia Dome tomorrow. I'm really looking forward to that one. It's Hennon throws. Searles can't get him. And he'll throw it away. And Hennon was leveled right when he got rid of the ball by Octavius Andrews.
He was trying to go down the field to Zach Allgood. They're a really outstanding wide receiver, and it was just, he was just covered up, had to throw it away. The winner of tomorrow's game Saturday, they will host the state championship game. So the winner of today's game will visit the winner of tomorrow's game.
This time Bobby Dover will come out and punt. His fourth punt of the game. So there is Stokes back deep. And Stokes will watch it bounce at the 15. Come back toward the 17, and that's where the Lincoln County Red Devils, up 16-0, will take over.
Trion's had the football five times today. They punted it four, and they've had the safety. So they just offensive output is just not, offense just can't get in the rhythm. Too much speed on this Red Devil defense. 2 minutes, John. This is a crucial time in every football game. 2 minutes for the half, 2 minutes at the end of the football game. And Coach Campbell has an outstanding plan with his two-minute offense. Let's see if he wants to put it into effect. He's going to the one back.
Tavius Andrews, the one back, three receivers. And on a keeper, it's Travis Clark.
Oh, he's
got 20. It. He may be running for a while. Cuts back and finally brought down. Thad Shives tried to bring him down, but had to wait until he got assistance by number 61, Brandon Espy. A 49-yard run by Travis Clark.
Nice start for two-minute offense. What a play call. It's the midline option, and the Red Devils used a spread formation, just outnumbered the Bulldogs on the corner, and here's Clark. Civil War hero Elijah Clark is buried in the Elijah Clark State Park in Lincolnton, Lincoln County. I don't know if Travis is related to Elijah Clark, but he's also going to be a hero playing like this.
Lincoln County wants timeout as they've crossed midfield all the way to the 38-yard line with a minute 29 to go in the first half. The Lincoln County Red Devils, they've won nine state championships under Larry Campbell, and they're going for number 10.
12 overall, John.
Yeah, 12 overall. It's a storied program in the state of Georgia.
Trion has won three since 1942.
On first down, out of the I formation. It's a flea flicker, and Clark is going downfield. It's going to be intercepted by Zach Ogden. No, he couldn't hold on. Stephen Brown was the intended receiver.
Sweep, reverse, flea flicker, pass. All right, how many trick plays is that now, John?
I think that's two.
I'm counting two. All right, we got 10 more to go.
But Zach Ogden became the receiver instead of Stephen Brown. And Brown knocked it out of his hands. Thought he had it.
All goods are really excellent. Outstanding wide receiver, defensive back. He's a senior, 165 pounders. Really, really.
Second down and 10. Barker throws. Looking toward Brown for the end zone. Incomplete. Thad Shives on the coverage. Great coverage there by Shives. And he'll bring up third down.
A little more conventional there, John. That was 45. That was just a little flick of the arm for Clark. He really didn't uncork it. He's an outstanding baseball player, college pro prospect as a baseball player.
Travis Clark transferred in from Evans High School. has been an outstanding quarterback for Lincoln County. And he's guided them to this Georgia Dome for the fifth time. Third down and 10, a minute 14 to go before the half. And Clark throws over the middle to Crike, incomplete. Too low. Corey Barnes there on the coverage.
It's going to bring up a fourth and 10. Let's see if Coach Campbell's going to gamble on fourth down here to go ahead and try to get points, or let Trion Bulldogs have the ball in pretty decent field position with about a minute to go for halftime. He's calling a play. Rolling the dice. His defense has played so well today. Go ahead and put a little pressure on them. They can do it.
And they may have just one more big play left in this first half. They've had several today.
Clark is a 59% pass completion on the season.
Fourth down and 10. A minute 8 to go. Clark's going to throw. And he's looking toward Brown. He's got it. First down at the 28. Shives on the coverage.
He put that football right between those two ones. What a shot. Here we go. Got his replay. See, he gets a deep drop. He sets up, gets under his feet, and he just sticks that football down sidelines. That's a NFL pass on an NFL football field.
Well, that to me is a confident quarterback.
He excellent passer. And then he'll talk about this offensive line. One of the coaches we talked to said this may be the best offensive line in the state of Georgia, bar none.
Clark, throw again. This time he's going to run. Across the 20. Blevins can't bring him down. He'll go out of bounds at the 9-yard line. Kevin Payton forces them out. But it's another first down.
And watch this block here at the end, John. Ronte Cummins, number 27, comes back, cracks back, makes a block for his quarterback, and it is unbelievable. Look at that strength.
That's stiff arm.
There you saw that crackback block. And he never went down.
Travis Clark's got all the tools. He can run, he can throw.
Leadership.
Leadership as well.
Great vision.
Very confident quarterback.
They're playing ahead, John. When you get ahead and get that momentum, and Coach Campbell's the master of play calling, when he gets ahead, you're in trouble.
First down and goal.
54 seconds.
Antonio Searles in motion. He's had a huge game. He gets the handoff. And he'll be dropped behind the line of scrimmage.
Red Devils calling timeout here. 44 seconds to go just for halftime. A score here can be a knockout punch.
Josh Hampton and Sly Purdy brings them down.
They faked the inside scissors, inside reverse. They faked it. Bulldog defense did a great job staying at home. Talking about playing defense horizontally, they've got this Bulldog defense strung out pretty much sideline to sideline just as well.
You know what I find interesting about Larry Campbell, Larry, is that in his years as head coach at Lincoln County, he's had one losing season, and that was his first season in 1972. They went 3-7. Ever since then, they have been a state power.
Yeah, how many high schools around the state of Georgia, coach comes in, they lose a game or two, and then all the, you know, they want to get rid of him. You know, they want instant results. Coach Dan Pitts, the number two on the all-time winning list in the state of Georgia, Mayor Pearson's High School that Coach Campbell passed last year, he grew up in Lincolnton. Did his student teaching there, went on to Mayor Pearson's and became number one state for several years until Coach Campbell passed him over for winning as coach. I'm sure Coach Pitts is here today.
363 wins, and it's all-time winningest coach.
State of Georgia. Number eight in the nation. He's in the National High School Football Hall of Fame.
The living legend walking the Georgia Dome today. Second down and goal. Clark's going to throw. Deep retreat. Goes to the end zone. Incomplete. Intended.
Ronce Cummins. They call Ronce and his teammate, Raquino Mickens, number 25, they call them the Mosquitoes. That's their mosquito attack on defense, so they will bite you. They're Mosquitoes. Played a big game last week against Metter.
39 seconds to go. They'll bring up a third and goal.
You see Coach Coach Campbell down there wearing that A for Abbeville, South Carolina. His best friend growing up, Coach Dennis Botts, head coach over there, died just a couple of days ago.
Third down and goal.
Wearing the A in honor of him.
39 seconds. Three receivers, two to the left. Buck will throw. Looking toward the end zone to Chris Kreit. Touchdown. And Lincoln County scores again. Travis Clark to Chris Kreit, and it's 22 to nothing. And another fine throw and catch. Fine throw by Travis Clark.
Crib Kreit. I can't get over his feet. That's where you throw the football, your feet. Your power comes from your lower body. He sets those feet, and then boom, that ball comes out of there like a cannon shot.
Josh Beard's been successful in his first two PATs. This one is blocked. And that was Corey Barnes, who came in to block the extra point to leave the score 22 to nothing.
JB didn't get there quite in time. A little slow in execution here. Great job there, Coach Barnes.
Now, Larry, what is Coach Loudermilk telling his troops right now? We got about 33 seconds left. As you take a look at the scoring drive, the 10-yard touchdown reception to Chris Kreit, 9 plays, 63 yards, about minute 21. Wow. But the team might be a little down right now.
Yeah, 33 seconds, looking for a squib kick. Don't fumble. You know, he's got his hands team out there looking for a squib kick, onside kick even with a Coach Campbell coach team. That may be onside kick. But let's regroup at halftime. He just wants to get out of here. 22 to nothing is bad enough. We just don't want to make any more mistakes before halftime. Lincolnton, about 35 miles northwest of Augusta. Right on the Savannah River in South Carolina, Abbeville, South Carolina, we've talked about. Named after Benjamin Lincoln, not Abraham Lincoln, Benjamin Lincoln, the Revolutionary War hero. There's Coach Campbell, great guy. Coach Loudermilk, great guy. These coaches we've talked to as we've gone around the state this past week, John, all great coaches. That, you know, that's the reason they're there. Squib kick.
Josh Beard will just pooch it up there, and a fair catch. Corey Barnes. Actually, it was Abernathy that made the fair catch, and Barnes made the catch. So Trion will take over at the 33-yard line. I have bet you they take a knee and just regroup at halftime.
Yes, I think so. I think a high school team's going to have a Hail Mary that's going to go about 70 yards in the air. So just regroup. Let's get our act together here at halftime. We're going to have to kick off to Lincoln County to open up the second half. So they've got to get that defense off the field and get them some rest.
Already down 22 to nothing. Hennon under center. He's going to throw. All good. Makes the catch. Tried to make a cut, but Stephen Brown was able to grab his shoestrings and bring him down.
Well, John, we're going to make any more predictions on what they're going to do using the timeout. It's just, you know, they're a high scoring, high powered offense, and they didn't get here because they played it safe. Here go replay, John. Little stop route. Lincoln County's playing deep, looking for some kind of a trick play or something. So they're giving them a lot of cushion, a lot of room. Good play call. Little stop route.
And I can see why they're throwing some passes. Now they need to get something positive before they head into the locker room, so that the team won't be two down coming back for the second half. And you mentioned that Lincoln County will be receiving the second half.
And their offense brought them to the dome. The defense has been a little bit suspect during the season, but their offense scoring 39 points a game, they've got to get some points on the board to get this thing going. And they've done it before. They score, they call it a grape offense. They score in bunches. And as soon as they break the ice and get in that end zone, then things will start popping and rolling.
Coach Loudermilk told me the other day the whole town of Trion may be coming down, and I see a lot of blue below us, Larry.
Yeah, 1,900, a little over 1,900 people in Trion are all here.
It's a big deal back up in the North Georgia Mountains. Hennon will throw, rolling out, and it's almost caught by Daniel Blevins.
That's an excellent pass. He threaded the needle right there. You'll see here on the replay, there's a linebacker, defensive back right in there, and he threads the needle.
Cummings got a hand on it.
Yeah, Ronsey, you know, here again, had the great game last week against Metter. Threw up about 60 passes against them.
There's the Trion fans. It's been a disappointing first half. But no matter what the outcome is, I'm sure it's well worth the trip to come down and watch their Bulldogs in the Georgia Dome.
Coach Leal right in the shadows of Lookout Mountain.
16 seconds to go before halftime. Hennon. He's going to keep it just short of midfield before he's brought down by Octavius Andrews. It'll be enough for a first down.
Got a timeout right here at 9 seconds.
Well, you can recall last year, as you take a look at Hennon's run in the Clinch County Hawkinsville game, Clinch County scored a touchdown right at the end of the first half and took all the momentum with them into the locker room and carried over in the second half. I'm sure Tryon's hoping to, if they don't score a touchdown, maybe get a big play and carry that momentum for the second half.
Yeah, these coaches, you know, you get into a lot of strategy and a lot of X's and O's, but it's emotion. You know, when you get down to basic facts, it's fundamental football, but you've got to play that naturally and then the big play, the big hit, and get that momentum. So Coach Loudermilk and his offensive staff, Coach Hatcher, looking for that one play, and once it gets to clicking, then it's a lot more positive. This offensive line for Trion was a little bit suspect early in the season. They have come on, done a great job. 213-pound average size.
Take a look at Brandon Hennon leading the troops. His favorite player is Peyton Manning, and I thought this was interesting. The reason why is because he stayed all 4 years at Tennessee. He didn't go and take the money early. He really respected them for that.
Yeah, I think that big T on their helmet has anything to do.
The blue version of Tennessee. 9 seconds to go. Hennon's going to throw. He's going toward the end zone. Looks like Abernathy. Incomplete. Actually, Corey Barnes.
Just a lead.
And that'll be
the
end of the half.
Still a good pass. About 50 yards in the air.
Well, Lincoln County has made a statement in the first half. 3 touchdowns. And it's 22-0. Lincoln County making their 5th appearance at the Georgia Dome. They've been here before and they're acting like it. And they'll carry that momentum into the second half. Trion, well, it's been a rough first half for them. Long snap went over the head of the punter, an interception return for a touchdown. We've had some things happen, but Coach Loudermilk will go in, rally the troops, and get them ready for the second half. 22-0, and let's hear from Gerald Oliveri.
Coach, you have 22 points right now, but your defense has really been the key. What's been the key to your defense holding their offense off?
Well, we always win football games with defense and kicking game and hope the head coach don't mess up calling the plays. Ball game ain't over, man. These guys are averaging right at 50 points in the playoff games alone, so it's far from over. We got to get some points on the board. We have not played well offensively. Played well defensively, but not offensively. That's my fault.
All right, thanks a lot, Coach. Back up to you, John.
Thank you, Gerald. Like a good coach, never satisfied. It's 22-0 as we go to halftime here on GPTV. At the halftime numbers, Larry Prather is dominated by the Red Devils.
93 passing yards, 120 rushing yards, 213 total yards for the Red Devils, only 84 for the Trion Bulldogs. Penalties, not a big factor. Turnovers, sort of big for the Trion Bulldogs, just the one. Time of possession, Trion is winning that game 17-650, but these Red Devils from Lincoln County are scoring in bunches.
It's not, what's the old saying? It's not how long you have the ball, it's what you do with it. Antonio Searles has been awesome for Lincoln County. We got a second half of football coming up. Lincoln County 22, Trion nothing. We're back with the Class Single A semifinal on GPTV. to the Georgia Dome. And Gerald Oliveri is standing by with Trion head coach Mark Loudermilk. Gerald?
Hey, coach, you normally run the ball a lot. Do you plan to go into the second half, continue to run, or do you have a different game plan?
No, we're just going to continue what we normally do, and that's try to, you know, get the ball, run the football and everything, and, you know, maybe throw some play-action passes, maybe hurt them.
How about, there was another game earlier in the season where your running attack didn't work so well, but your passing attack, Hennon, came along well. How do you think that's going to work in this game?
You know, that was a few weeks ago, about 6 weeks ago, and, you know, we're going to throw a little bit more to kind of open things up. We just got to go out there and try to execute and tackle and just play football. You know, I think we're a little bug-eyed, but hopefully now our nerves are kind of jittered, down, and we'll go play.
You think that was the reason for the turnovers?
I don't know. Probably that. Probably get hit a little bit, too. And, you know, all the excitement. It's a big to-do for all these kids and everything. But hopefully we're calm down now and can play some football.
So what'd you say to them at halftime?
This is a once-in-a-lifetime chance. We don't never know. We better make the most of it as we can. You know, they need to come out and they're Bulldogs, and they need to take pride in what they do. You know, they wear that little sticker on their hats that says pride. And it's a gut check now from here on out these next 24 minutes.
There it is. Well, thanks a lot, Coach.
Appreciate it. Thank you.
I'm going to go back up to you, John.
Thank you, Gerald. Looks like Domitis may have reared its ugly head to Trion, Larry.
Yes, and opening up the second half, look for an onside kick. I mean, why are you going to give that football to that high-powered offense from Lincoln County? So, you know, you got nothing to lose. You got 24 minutes to make something happen. And Coach Loudermilk's got a bag of tricks of his own.
Well, a huge contingent has come to the Georgia Dome from Lincolnton. Of course, they know that route very well. This is the fifth trip to the Georgia Dome for the Lincoln County Red Devils since they've been playing the semifinals here.
They're tied with Parkview and Washington County for most appearances at the Dome, 5 times for each team.
You take a look at Daniel Blevins, Corey Day, and the rest of the Trion Bulldogs. We're live from the Georgia Dome. John Wilkerson, Larry Prather, and Gerald Oliveri with you for this Class Single A state semifinal. Trion down 22-0. It's been a tough get-go for them in this one. They're coming out fired up for the second half. We've got several more games coming up here on GPTV today. Vidalia and Charlton County will battle after this one, approximately kick time around noon, and then Washington County, 12-1, takes on the Grangers of LaGrange. That's 3A and 4A. Well, that's Thomas County Central and Marist, a rematch of last year's semifinal game that was a classic. And in 5A, well, the Noonan Cougars, fresh from their upset of the Parkview Panthers, three-time defending champion, take on Camden County, unbeaten in Class 5A. Well, tomorrow it's another rematch in class single A. Clinch County Hawkinsville met last year. They'll meet again in the semifinals. That's a game I'm really looking forward to. In 2A, Decatur takes on the Buford Wolves. Buford going after another state championship in 2A. In 3A, Spalding takes on Peach County. In 4A, Statesboro and Tucker making their first Dome appearance. And in 5A, Valdosta, well, they know the route here as well. They'll take on the Westside Seminoles. And curious not to see the Parkview Panthers in a 5A semifinals. Kickoff is taken by Brown. Across the 30 to the 35-yard line, and that's where Lincoln County will take over in the second half. Zach Allgood on the tackle.
And needless to say, the Bulldogs did not do an onside kick. Try to pin them up, get them back as far as they can, and make them drive the field. Coach Campbell's talking right there before halftime about the Red Devil offense not being very productive, even though they got 22 points. I think what he's talking about is both of their touchdowns came off of passes plus the interception. So I think he's wanting to get a ground game going to get his offense into a tempo, start grinding this clock a little bit.
Two receivers to the right side of the field. Two back split. C.J. Norman on the carry. Look at the line of scrimmage and fumble. And Trion's got it. Corey Barnes. And Trion gets the big break right off the bat, Larry.
Coach Corey Barnes. He's the third fastest player. He's a 4.5 40 except. You see, he's right here in the spot. Unbalanced formation. Lincoln County's got to help Trion out just a little bit. First turnover of the game for the Red Devils.
and it gives Trion their best field position of the game at the Lincoln County 40-yard line. Let's see if they'll take advantage of it. Brandon Hennon under center. And the Trion Bulldog fans are rooting them on, and they'll give it to the fullback, and he'll get a couple of yards. Corey Day.
Wishbone Veer, establish the middle, establish that fullback, opens up the whole offense. Here you go, see the replay. Quarterback reading the option. I think they probably told him, go ahead and give it. Let's make this fullback inside belly, fullback dive, fullback Veer. We've got to establish that.
It's a 3-yard pickup, second down and 7. They've had some success with Day running up the middle. He's not afraid of contact. As Blevins is in motion, he gets the pitch. Good block by Chapman, and he's hogtied just short of the first down by Jarius Wynn. Be a couple yards short of the first down. They'll bring up third down.
This is a touchdown saving tackle. Just gets him right by the collar. He made the move to get down the sideline. A lot of green grass to the end zone. Touchdown saving. Also saved the first down. Brings up a third down, John.
Boy, you can just see the tempo of Trion right now picking up. They were a little down at the halftime, at the end of the first half. But now that turnover has just changed things. 82 yards of total offense today for the Trion Bulldogs on third down and 3. And they give it to the fullback, Day. Gets to the 30. That's where he had to get the first down. Forward progress will get him beyond the 30. So it appears to be a first down. Drum long brings him down.
Trion offense is their best defense. They've got to keep the ball away from the blue Red Devils. And you can see the belly with the fullback. Got the big first down. Momentum definitely on the side of Trion at this point. Bulldogs are moving. They average 39 points a game. You got to get some points on this drive.
It's a first down for the Trion Bulldogs. Chapman in motion. He'll get the pitch. It's a block from Blevins. It's across the 25, the 20, 15. Knocked out of bounds at the 11.
Tavares
Stokes and Stephen Brown.
He's giving a coaching clinic on how to run the football. You get down, get under your pads. BYOB, be your own blocker. Get down low. Watch him dip this shoulder. Get down and use that leg strength. Use those shoulder pads. Oh, he's quick. He's strong. Great balance.
And so far, Trion is taking advantage of the gift given to him by Lincoln County. First and 10 at the 12. Zach Allgood. And Kyle Abernathy on the right side as your receivers. And Blevins on the counter. He'll get to the 5.
Oh, they're rocking and rolling. They're 2 plays ahead of the Lincoln County defense now. They've got things going their way.
Alex Weidman was there after the 7-yard pickup.
We've got a timeout with the Devils.
And so Larry Campbell will call timeout. He sees momentum flowing on the Trion side now. He's got to do something to stop it.
You see Clarence's grandson, 79 yards rushing today. Momentum is on the side of the Dogs. Dome Dogs, or is it going to be Dome Devils?
Well, finally, the Trion fans, all dressed in their blue, have something to cheer about.
Yeah, they're on their feet. Trion got its name from a trio of investors that built the first mill along a little creek there in northeast Georgia. The Trio named it the Trio. Then became Trion. So in Chattooga County, you have a football power. Trion High School, the Bulldogs. Coach Loudermilk.
You know, Coach Loudermilk was telling me that they had made up T-shirts for the fans, and they were gone within a day, and they had to order more. They were in such high demand. We saw a fan earlier wearing one of those T-shirts.
He's taking a lot of medication for walking pneumonia. You see he looks peaky. It's not the game. It's the pneumonia. Unbalanced formation, John.
On second down and 3, you got to get to the 2-yard line and get another first down. Chapman on the pitch. Able to get a few yards. Close to the first down. We'll mark him out at the 3. Tay at a yard short of the first down.
Tay Andrews came off of an inside blitz. You'll see right here on the replay. Tay Andrews had him and just couldn't quite get there. Just too much speed. Chapman's
the fastest guy on the team.
4.440, maybe 4.3 on this turf. Talk to the coaches, players. the turf is not a factor. The noise level in this dome is just astonishing to them.
Well, Trion worked out twice this week at Rose Bowl Field at Georgia Tech, which has the same turf, and they loved it. They saw no difference. And this is Day looking to get in the end zone, caught from behind. He's going to be short of the first down. Drum long on the tackle for Lincoln County.
Clogged in the middle, and he tried to bounce outside. You see it's a fullback belly isolating the linebacker, and he tried to bounce outside. Too much speed on this Red Devil defense to bounce. You've got to take what you got and stick it north and south. Can't run east and west on these guys. Fourth down, a yard for a touchdown, 2 yards. A yard for first down, 2 yards for the touchdown, 3 yards for the touchdown.
Twice, Trion has gone for it on fourth down and been successful.
Red Devils normally only give up about 75% of the time, 25% of the time.
Clevins on the sweep. He's got the first down. He'll be short of the goal line.
Be the first down, though. Said his knee was down, slipped.
He slipped on the turf. He had an easy path to the end zone, but the turf got him.
You can see here, pitch, quick pitch, knee down, but he got the first down. That's what's important.
So Trion's now 3 for 3 on fourth down conversions.
Great play call. Good. These officials on top of their game. Middle Georgia Fish Association doing a great job.
First half, 5 first downs, 3 on this drive for the Trion Bulldogs, and they're hoping to tack on 6 points as they get to Day. He's in there. Touchdown, Trion. Daniel Blevins on the carry. And I'm sure Grandpa is cheering Daniel right now. Finally, Trion breaks the deadlock, and it's 22-6, and they're going to go for 2. All good. The lone receiver. The pitch goes to Chapman. Chapman cuts and gets 2 points. And the momentum is all on Trion in the second half. And the fans have made their way down from the North Georgia Mountains, finally can have something to cheer about. The Trion Bulldogs are on the board, 22-8.
Free play, John, on this 2-point conversion. Toss, sweep. Just old 49 sweep. And you see the effort to get in the end zone. Same place old Michael Vick made his dive last week.
So Chris Chapman scores on the 2, 22-8. 8 plays, 40 yards. Daniel Blevins with a 1 yard touchdown run. It took up a little over 3 minutes of time.
Here again, they run that banana offense. They score in bunches as well. Up in Trion, it's Sam McCain Stadium. It's Blevins Field, Clarence Blevins Field. His grandson, Daniel, may have something to do in renaming. Here we go again, John, on the replay for the touchdown. It's their counter, going to the counter game, base blocking. Great run, great vision. Can't say enough. He's speedy, he's quick, he's fast. He gets on his shoulder pads, but he's nifty in his vision.
Lincoln County back to receive the kick. And they do so. Joaquino Mickens, hard on the seat of his britches. And so, well, what does Larry Campbell have planned now that their defense gave up a touchdown, 22-8? He's used 3 tricks already.
Yeah, this year, Lincoln County's only been behind twice in the whole season. They're ahead now, 22-9, but only twice this season have they been behind. Both times when they got behind, they drove the length of field, scored touchdowns to take the lead. So let's see if they can answer the bell here.
You don't want to corner Larry Campbell. He's got plenty of experience and knows how to coach this game of football. 1st and 10. And Clark will keep it and buried at the 15-yard line, Brandon Espy. Oh, Coach Loudermilk loves that effort from his defense.
Great defensive call. Tom Bryant, defensive coordinator. Great call. Here you go. Replay the midline option, and they smelled it out. Now he knew that he was not going to hand that football off.
Well, the defense has come alive for Trion.
And they're the reason why they put 8 points on the board. And on second down, quick pitch or quick throw to Stephen Brown. He can't handle it. It'll bring up third and long.
Stephen scored the first touchdown of the game. He's got good hands. It's just a hot, that's a hot ball to handle.
Well, the Trion defense has pinned its ears back and just letting it all hang out.
Omo is in the house. 50 defense. This Trion defense is just awesome. We got a lot of this from Rodney Walker at Sandy Creek when he was at Peach County. Excellent 50 defense.
Third and 13. And they'll give it to Andrews, and Andrews maybe gets a yard. Brought down by number 71, Jason Brooks. And it's three and out for the Lincoln County Red Devils.
You see that concern on Coach Campbell's face. He knows the game is not over. Is Trion going to rush 10? They've got 10 on the line. Let's see if all 10 come. Would Coach Campbell gamble here inside the 20? Would he gamble on a fake punt? You never know with that guy. He's the Fox, the Gray Fox.
Well, his quarterback, Travis Clark, does the punting.
There's 10 up the line.
Blocked well. Allgood will take it in midfield. Gets to the 40 and ridden down there.
At a wall, Johnny, at a wall. Just one.
Rakino Mickens on the tackle. A 10-yard return by Zach Allgood. And with all the momentum in the world behind him, Trion will take over at the Lincoln County 40. Lincoln County looks a bit stunned, Larry.
They are. I'm stunned. You know, great field position. You scored a touchdown. You got a two-point conversion. You got 8 points up. And they are a juggernaut when you let them get momentum. Their offense is the best defense. Unbiased formation, John.
Abernathy and that's the pitch goes, or the handoff goes to Day. And Day will get 10 yards, maybe 9 yards. Brought down by Tavares Stokes.
And they didn't tackle him. He just lost his balance. They didn't tackle him. He's still going. What a player. What, this whole backfield, these backs, quarterbacks, backs, that's four complete football players. Talking to Coach Campbell and defensive coordinator Ellis, he said, you know, pick your poison. Any one of these guys can beat you with their speed and savvy and quickness and toughness. They're just tough kids from Trion. Have that reputation forever.
It's second down. It's just short of the first down. And on the keeper has the first down and a lot more to the 15-yard line. Josh Beard and Rakino Mickens there to make the stop. Oh, the dog fans are barking at the dome. And here's Brandon Hennon, Larry.
He's tough. Remember Rick Camp, the Braves baseball pitcher? Tough, tough guy. He's from Trion. What does that tell you about these Trion kids?
They're a bunch of good old mountain boys from North Georgia. And they've come to the big city, the big dome. And they're putting on a good performance in the second half. And it's Blevins on the counter. He's got it open. He gets to the five.
Oh, quick. Oh, quickness. He's quick as a hiccup. Counter play. That was just base blocking counter. Nothing fancy. Oh, what a move. They've got this Lincoln County defense strung out wide. They need to call a timeout.
Daniel Blevins with 59 yards today here at the Dome.
Most
they mark him at the six, second down and one.
Most of that came here in the second half.
It's Day, the fullback, across the five, maybe to the three. A wall of Lincoln County Red Devils are there to meet him.
And they still haven't gotten him down. He's still up. He's ran the ball three times this quarter, and he still hasn't gone down. They just stack him up. It's taken three or four guys to hold him.
You know, as they mark him at the three-yard line, you know, Trion's not doing anything different than they did in the first half, and Lincoln County did a good job stopping it. Now they just look like they're on their heels and just don't know what hit them. First and goal for Trion. Two receivers, that's Blevins in motion. Blevins gets the pitch. And he's hauled down behind the line of scrimmage. Drum long and Ronci Cummings were there, along with Octavius Andrews.
Let's give credit to this Trion offensive line. Here we go. We got a replay. Got the toss sweep. It's been effective for them. This Red Devil defense is strung out, but they're there. They're in a great position for it. This offensive line for Trion, amazing. Kevin Patton, 195 pounds. Michael Lively, 265, college prospect at left guard. Brother Zach at center, 190.
It's a patchwork offensive line. They lost a lot in graduation, but they've come on as the playoffs have started. On second down and goal, Blevins gets back to the original line of scrimmage at the three, and that's it.
It's going to bring up a third down,
Weidman and Beard on the tackle.
Third down about three, but remember we're in four down zone here, so they backed it up just a little bit. It's on the three and a half. Got two downs to get it in the end zone.
You did take a look at Daniel Blevins. His favorite player is LeVar Arrington of the Redskins, and the reason why is because of his intensity. But he also likes Michael Vick, and who doesn't? Third down and goal. And the pitch of Chapman looking for an alley in the end zone. He's got a touchdown, Trion.
Replay, John. What a momentum breaker. See, Daniel Blevins making the key block. When you got a wishbone offense, if you're not running the ball, you got a block. Great block. Great running from Chapman. Great blocking from Blevins.
Tevita Mihai with the extra point. And it's wide to the left. And so we'll stay at 22-14. And Coach Loudermilk sees momentum and has seized it twice. Two touchdowns, and the Trion Bulldogs are back in the game. Chris Chapman, an alley to the end zone. And Larry, has Larry Campbell seen something like this before? I'm sure he has.
In 34 years, he's seen it all, John. He knows exactly what he's doing. He'll calm them down, get them. The whole thing got started with the fumble, the turnover. Let's look at the touchdown one more time. It's their toss sweep. They've been running it effectively all day long, and see great blocking from his teammate. Daniel Blevins got him in the end zone. 8 points. 8 points on the day for Chris Chapman. Talking about Trion and Rick Camp from there. Stacy Searles is an offensive line coach at LSU, trying to win a national championship. Wallace Clark, a running back from Trion, All-American, played for the Falcons from Trion.
7 plays, 39 yards. Took over 3 minutes, almost 4 minutes, and Chapman's 3-yard touchdown run makes it 22-14. Stephen Brown and Tavares Stokes are back for the Red Devils. And a huge kick taken by Stokes. Right at the goal line, gets to the 20, to the 30. Big return by Stokes all the way to the 34-yard line. Josh Hampton there to stop him.
Lincoln County is the second leading defense in the state, Class A. They don't get to practice kickoff returns during games. They don't allow people to score, so they only get to see probably one kickoff per game. So very, very, very effective kickoff return. See if they can snatch the momentum back.
In two offensive possessions in the second half, Lincoln County has lost it on a turnover and gone 3 and out. Only 3 yards this half for Lincoln County. And first down, Clark will keep it and thrown down for a loss. Micah Lively.
Micah, 260-pound college prospect. They have got a tendency, they have picked up a big-time tendency that Travis keeps the football on first down. So the last two series, they have smelled out some kind of tendency. Coach Campbell does not have many tendencies. Talking to him yesterday, they spend hours scouting themselves so that they don't have tendencies, but Trion has picked up something.
3 yard loss, second down and 13. Clark on a keeper again. Across the 35, to short of the 40. The positive yards for the Red Devils as Matt Brooks and Josh Hampton are there to stop them.
Coach Bryant, defense coordinator for Trion, has done an excellent job of scouting and getting a flow for the football game to know what these Red Devils are going to do to them. You've got to be impressed with Trion's defense as well. They're quick. They've come out inspired here in the second half. Good speed this defense. Good quickness.
Third down and five. Out of the I formation. For the Lincoln County Red Devils. That's Mickens.
Oh, I'm sorry. What a play. Great play.
Great play as Josh Hampton makes the stop on the carry by Mickens.
Senior, 160-pounder. Great play. He got down there, squatted. Here you see on the replay, he's blocked. He's blocked. He gets underneath it, gets up, makes a play in the backfield.
And once again, it's going to be three and out for the Lincoln County Red Devils.
Slow. The Red Devils are slow getting their punt team on the field. I'm wondering if Coach has called a trick play here, fake punt. Every play, John, you got to be looking for something special from both these coaches, both these teams. Fake punt, possibly.
Parker do the honors. He's going to kick it. All good is there. Fielded at the 25. The block. The short of the 35. Josh Beard was there on the tackle on special teams. And so Trion's first two possessions in the second half have led to touchdowns. Both on the Lincoln County side of the field. Now they'll work on the other side of the 50. And Matt Brooks is being treated on the sideline for Trion.
Working on his calf muscles. Yeah, maybe cramps. They're coming off his turf. Calves will cramp up. Worst field position Trion's had here in the second half. We're on 34.
Dave. And he stood up at the line of scrimmage. Drum long. Was there. Weidman and the rest of the Lincoln County Red Devils. And now they're starting to get fired up on defense.
Establishing the fullbacks. And Stephanie is a fullback veer. Nothing special about the blocking there. Just get off the football quick. Get up in the linebacker's face and let him make a cut on the veer.
And we got a player down, and it's Chapman. Chris Chapman.
So he got the breath knocked out of him. See Hennon talking to Coach Loudermilk.
Well, they can't afford to lose Chris Chapman.
Trion High School has a reputation for years for being a tough, hard-nosed football team. It's hard for them to schedule games. People don't want to play them, even though they may 5A and 4A, they don't want to play them. And Chapman's coming out, but he's walking. I think he just got the breath knocked out of him. We'll see him back here in a minute. See Coach.
This is a big game. He's not going to want to stay on the sideline. He's a big contributor to this Trion offense.
Yeah. Coach Loudermilk's wife, Julie, trainer, working with him. That'll get him back in here.
Matt Brooks is back in after getting some treatment on the sidelines. Second down and 11. Give it to Day. Day cuts. And it's knocked down by Rikino Mickens.
One of the backs moved a little quick, John. I think it's going to be a legal procedure. It'll come back. Unless Coach Campbell wants to use the down. They didn't gain that much yardage. Coach Campbell may decline the penalty. It's only going to be a 5-yarder, so he may take the play. Try to get the ball back a little sooner. And I think Coach Campbell will back him up.
Yeah, back him up.
There you go.
Take a look at Hennon. Brandon Hennon.
Coming with a 185-pound senior, part of that dynamic. Four back, the four horsemen of Trion. They'll make them forget about Wallace Clark, running back out of Trion, set the state record in Class B. Herschel Walker broke his record in 100-yard dash.
Illegal motion, offense, 5-yard penalty from the previous spot, second down.
You mentioned about Brandon Hennon. He has a 2.9 GPA. And of course, Coach Loudermilk calls him the boss on the field. He's in control when he's under center. And he's done a great job in the second half. Second and 16 after the penalty. And that's Blevins, and he'll fake it, and he's going to throw it. Looking for Day. He's got him. First down to the 47-yard line. Stephen Brown on the stop.
Hammond has three touchdown passes on the season. He's seven touchdowns on the season. He's a 54% passer. And watch how he sets his feet, throws the ball on the move. pinpoint, actually. Great catch. Good hands today.
Corey Day usually doesn't catch a lot of passes, but today he did.
Boots and waggles. They lull you to sleep with all this misdirection running, then all of a sudden they get fullback with the tight end out in the flats and the wide open. He was wide open.
Bulldogs continue to march. First and 10 at their own 37-yard line. That's Day again. He's been a workhorse on this drive, and he keeps pounding and pounding, and he was knocked down just short of the 45, Octavius Andrews.
Great blocking. John, this KP, Kevin Patton and Michael Lively over on the left side, they've taken control of left side line of scrimmage. I think they're going to let the clock run out, John. It's about 3 seconds.
Winding down to the end of the third quarter. What a third quarter for the Trion Bulldogs. They get on the board and are in the game. 22-14, Lincoln County, the fourth quarter when we come back. Georgia Dome, where we've had a change of momentum here as Lincoln County up 22-0 at halftime, now find themselves up only 22-14 in the Class Single A semifinal. We start the fourth quarter, and the second half momentum has been all Trion. Second down and 3 from the 48. And they give it to Day, and Day, a big fullback. What a day he's had. Andrews and Ronci Cummings knock him out of bounds.
This offensive line for Trion, John, they just can't get over how this offensive line is taken over. Here you go. You see the replay. This is just fullback Veer. Basic football. Base blocking. Day does a great job running through tackles.
I get the feeling this is like a tough bully that's gotten his first hit in the mouth. Lincoln County. I mean, ever since that, as you take a look at Corey Day's number, 69 yards. But ever since that turnover, and I guess trying to use a metaphor here, maybe hit him in the mouth for the first time, they haven't been the same.
This hadn't been the same. It's just, you know, they cannot regain momentum. Look for Coach Campbell to come up with a trick play. Here's something. The trick plays usually don't work when you're getting hit in the mouth. They're having to call a timeout. But you see these Trion football players, all their heads shaved. Got a tradition. When you go to the Dome, you shave your hair. Looks good. But you saw Corey Day there just a second ago, 185-pound senior fullback. He's a load.
Well,
John, I'm sorry, going back to this offensive line, talking about Zach Lively at 190-pound center, Matt Brooks at right guard, 215 pounds, and Seth Lindsay, father Richard, is the superintendent, 215-pound sophomore right tackle. And then I don't want to leave out Brandon Espy. He's played a ball game on both sides. 185-pound senior offensive defensive lineman. You see Coach Campbell was really, really
tight. Awesome. Game can also be viewed live on the GPTV internet site at www.gpp.org. Just follow the links to connect to the game. All the games from the Dome this weekend will be archived and available on the GPP website as well. That's www.gpp.org. So check us out on your PC. Well, the Trion Bulldogs continue to move. 108 total yards in the third quarter for Trion, only 12 for Lincoln County.
And what a game Ronci Cummings has had. They've had to take him out. He's gassed. Got to get his breath back, get him back in the ballgame for these Red Devils on defense.
First and 10 for the Trion Bulldogs. Chapman back in the game. He'll get the pitch. Looking for an alley. And he's knocked down just short of the 20 by Stephen Brown.
Daniel Blevins back in the ballgame, throwing the block down the field for him. So it's good to see Chapman back in the ballgame. They're going to need him down here on the goal line.
Chris Chapman carries a 3.0 GPA. His favorite football player is Michael Vick. As you take a look at the run. And the person that he looks up to, Larry, is his father, Gary Chapman. He tells me he used to play in the backyard, play a little toss football, and that meant a lot to him.
Ooh, look at this formation. Unbalanced, big splits.
from the 20. Second down. And the pitch goes to Daniel Blevins. They'll get to the 25-yard line, a yard short of the first down. Jarius Wynn, along with...
And you can see right here, it's Darius comes in, makes a shoestring tackle. He may have been gone. He might have had a seam right there. Could have scored. But this Trion offense is really, really something else. They use all
3 of 11 on third down conversions for Trion. Of course, they're batting 1,000 in fourth down conversions.
But most of those conversions 32. Came here in the second half, John.
Chapman in motion. Day is met at the line of scrimmage by Alex Weidman. Just a little, maybe short of the first down, depends on the mark.
Just short. I think they got him right at line of scrimmage. That was a strong tackle. You can see how strong Josh Beard is. Big JB, 225 pounds. He is a load linebacker.
It's fourth down, and they're going to go for it. They've been perfect on fourth down conversions.
Three for three. Lincoln County normally is successful 75% of the time on fourth down this year.
Chapman on the sweep. He's got the first down.
And they score.
And he's down to the two.
What a block, Chris Chapman. What a block downfield, Chris Chapman. Not only they run the ball well, they block well.
C.J. Norman on the stop. But it's another first down and goal as Chris Chapman does it all. Look at those spins.
Great block. Daniel Blevins down the field.
Chris Chapman's favorite subject is English at Trion High School.
First down on the two, John.
And Hennon gives it to Chapman again. Touchdown, Bulldogs. They've got the lead.
Got to go for two.
Well, no, they got
down
by
two.
I was never good at math class. Chris Chapman. On the touchdown.
John, what would you do? 9 minutes to go in the fourth quarter. And Chalk says you got to go for two here. Got to go for two. Oh, man, what a block. Kyle Abernathy tied in for these Trion Bulldogs. What a block. They're fast, but, man, they're tough. They block.
And Chapman gets the pitch. They get 2 points, and we're tied. What a game for Chris Chapman.
Replay, John. Here's your touchdown. Counter, the counter series. Give credit this offensive line. Give credit these back. You see big 72 there blocking downfield.
And watch the reaction to the fans from Trion. Three charter buses and two school buses full of fans came down from the North Georgia Mountains to cheer on their Bulldogs. 73 yards rushing for Chris Chapman today. Two touchdowns. He's been the man, along with Corey Day, for the Trion Bulldogs.
Two touchdowns and a two-point conversion, giving him 14 points. He's the leading scorer on the day.
And it's at 9 plays, 66 yards, a little over 4 minutes. Chapman with the touchdown run and the two-point conversion. And looking out in the field there, you can see there's a bounce in the step of the Trion Bulldogs. And there's just not that bounce at all with Lincoln County. They're just kind of moping around.
They're stunned. They've been hit in the mouth. They can't believe the momentum. Oh,
Steven Brown.
Oh, my goodness.
Looking for place to run. And he's not. Corey Day brings him down to 10.
You coach your kids when the ball is bouncing inside the 10. You let it bounce and go in the end zone. But on this new turf, it just doesn't bounce. And it's sort of poetic justice. That's the way the ball's been bouncing here the whole second half for these Red Devils. The ball bounced out of the back, away from the end zone. See the concern on Coach Campbell's face.
He starts his offensive possession deep at their own 10-yard line with all the momentum on the Bulldog side. Now, Larry, do they need a big play here?
Big play. The play they're calling, having to call timeout. I don't think they had enough players on the field. Mental. Domitis has reached up and grabbed him here in the second half.
And that's surprising. This is the fifth time Lincoln County has made an appearance at the Georgia Dome. Larry Campbell, he knows the route to the Dome just as good as anybody from Lincolnton. But Domitis has reared its ugly head on this team, this Lincoln County team, in the second half.
You see the calm demeanor. There's no hollering and screaming. He's under control.
Well, as you take a look at Larry Campbell talking to the troops, let's hear what he likes about coaching.
I think it had 34 years, a long time, and I think the greatest part about it to me is seeing former players come back here that have been successful, made something of themselves, whether it's been pro ball, college ball, or the armed forces or whatever. And after a Friday night win and those kids coming up and you see them and they got their families and things like that, you know, and just building character. And I think it keeps you young, a little young yourself, you know, when you're doing it for 34 years.
And among one of Coach Campbell's alums, the San Francisco 49er running back Garrison Hurst, as Clark has caught the backfield. Zach Allgood. And it's a 3-yard loss.
Zach brought all 165 up there. What a load. The 210-pound quarterback, he unloads.
Travis Clark never had a chance. 2-yard loss or 3-yard loss. Second down and 13 coming up for the Lincoln County Red Devils.
Got to have a big play to get some kind of momentum. And just besides momentum, we need a first down. Got to get that first down somehow. Coach Campbell's racking his brain.
Clark retreats his goal line, throws over the middle, pass caught at the 15-yard line, all the way to 22, drum long.
Flag down. Right on the 5-yard line, right in the area for offensive holding. This could be a death blow for this Red Devil offense.
Holding. Now holding on Lincoln County. Boy, what a difference between the first half and the second half of this one.
Yeah, these kids, they're undefeated. This is a 13-0 football team. They don't have any give up in them. They've got 8.5 minutes to go. And you see Coach Campbell racking the brain. We need one play. Need one play to get that momentum to get out of this hole. And we don't need anything negative to happen. So he's racking his brain for
holding
that special play.
Offense, 10, half the distance to the goal. Repeat, second down.
Puts the ball around the 1-yard line, and that'd be a second down and 20.
But I think this Trion offense has really inspired the defense. This defense has played 100% better in the second half. Great job, Coach Bryant.
Well, this whole momentum started with a fumble recovery by the Trion defense. Puck in his end zone. He stepped out of bounds and into safety. He stepped on the back line, rolling out, trying to make the throw, and it's 24-22 Trion.
And they've got to kick off to Trion. Lincoln County's got to kick off. The Bulldogs are going to get the football in great field position with 8:17 to go in the fourth quarter. What a break for the Bulldogs.
Well, officials are huddling.
He's the head official that made the call. He was right there on top of it, getting the notes together here on the safety and a semifinal state championship game. You're going to be sure, double check. These officials have done an outstanding job. They are in playoff form, state championship form themselves. Great job, Middle Georgia Association.
Boy, it just seems like the wheels have totally fallen off the Lincoln County Express.
Just totally unbelievable. We thought it would be a little bit low scoring, 24-22. It's not low scoring to me, but they're used to scoring 40, 50 points a game. But the wheels have come off, John.
Yeah, you heard the official right there tell Coach Campbell that his foot was on the line before he got rid of the football. Travis Clark's foot.
See Coach Ellis, defensive coordinator.
Well, look at Coach Loudermilk. He's got walking pneumonia. But, boy, I tell you, being up by 2 points is good medicine.
What an effort from him. What an effort from these kids from Northeast Georgia, the pride of Northeast Georgia, the pride of Chattooga County.
Josh Beard will kick it off from a tee. You have the option after a safety to punt it, kick it off a tee. Chris Chapman back deep.
Dogs are going to get this football in. Excellent field position. 8:17 to go in the fourth quarter.
Corey Barnes back deep as well.
8 minutes away from the state championship game.
Barnes will take it at the 33. 35. It's just short of midfield. Antonio Searles, who had a huge first half, makes the tackle.
John, let's look at this safety. You see the official is back there right on top of this thing. Travis is making a great move. Used his stiff arm to get time to throw the pass, and that right foot stepped right on the line. Great call, great play from Micah Lively, All-State football player from Trion.
Could be costly. As Trion takes over at their own 48, first and 10. Two receivers on the left, Corey Day. Big haul, across the 45 to the 43. Ronci Cummings on the tackle. And the Express of Trion, it continues the roll.
What a difference all this field position makes. That early fumble from Lincoln County to open up the second half. And Trion has had the football in great field position ever since. They had it on their own 34 there one time. And here you go, second half possessions, three TDs, three possessions.
That's making the most of your opportunities. Second down and two. After the 8-yard pickup by Corey Day, here's Daniel Blevins to the line of scrimmage, maybe a yard. Alex Weidman on the stop.
It's going to be a little short, John. It's going to be third and a little less than one. But look where they got the football. They're in the Lincoln County side of the 50. Fourth down to this Trion team. Coach Loudermilk, fourth down is just a regular old play, man. Talk about a high-octane, high-powered offense.
Daniel Blevins' favorite subject is math. Why? Because he likes numbers. Well, he's been racking up the numbers on the ground today against Lincoln County.
And Lincoln County sure doesn't have his number.
On third down, it's Corey Day to the 40. Has a first down. Lakino Mickens on the stop.
John, the noise in this dome just echoes. And even though it may be a small crowd in comparison to the NFL crowd, this 3,000 folks here from Trion are really racking this down. It's just rattling through here. It's hard to hear yourself think. These players on the sideline have to get right there with the coach to hear what's going on. See the Red Devils sideline really subdued.
Very subdued now after really making some noise in the first half. First and 10 for Trion at the 40. As Daniel Blevins in motion, they'll give it to Corey Day. And Day gets across the 35. To the 34-yard line, perhaps the 33, depends on forward progress. Brought down by Jarris Wynn. Corey Day, his favorite player is Deion Sanders. Well, he's been the primetime performer so far, one of the primetime performers for Trion.
First down plays, give credit to offensive line, give credit to Coach Hatcher. First down plays, their production has gone up tremendously. They're getting around 6-7 yards on first down, and that puts their offense into motion. They just momentum. It's so fluid.
Second and three. Chapman in motion. Corey Day again. He's been the workhorse to the 30. That's where he had to get to the first down. Josh Beard on the stop for Lincoln County.
They list Day about 180, 590 pounds, but one of these Lincoln County defenders can't stop him one-on-one. They're having to gang tackle. Takes two, three guys to get him down.
90 yards already for Corey Day.
4.5-yard average. And I guarantee you it was a 1-yard average in the first half. So he has done it here in the second half.
He likes to mix it up in the trenches, Coach. His coach told me. Hard nose, likes contact, Coach Loudermilk said. He's not afraid to get his uniform dirty. Of course, it's kind of hard on this turf. And on third down, it's Day again. He stood up at the line of scrimmage and probably marked short of the first down. Drum Long was there to stop him.
There's
and there was a fumble. And Lincoln County has it.
5 minutes, 2 seconds in the fourth quarter. Here you go, replay. How did they get that ball out of there?
Stripped it right. Just stripped him, and Day couldn't recover, although it came up right back to him. Keno Mickens.
Ronci Cummings.
Ronci Cummings, I'm sorry.
Yes. Lincoln County with that one big turnover. That's Trion's second turnover. Let's see if this is going to be the momentum puncher. But 33, 32-yard line is a long way from the end zone for this Red Devil offense.
Well, they can put up points in a hurry. And Clark retreats. Now runs. Being chased by Blevins. He can't get him. And pushed out of bounds.
Smart, smart play. He made something positive happen out of something that could have been negative.
Craig
got
Beck.
Offense into get their offense, get a little momentum with their offense, get a little.
Here's what Lincoln has done in the second half. Fumble, two punts and a safety, 10 yards of offense in the second half.
Exactly like you said, John, the wheels have come off this Lincoln County offense. Gained about 6 yards there on that first down play. First time they've had a positive gain on first down in the second half.
But Clark continues to be harassed.
Going to the
defensive line. Out of shotgun. What? Now being rushed. Throws complete. No, drop. Chris Kreit had it in his hands.
He was wide open. He was there. Great read. Look at Coach Campbell. Oh, man, he's suffering. Third down and four. Big third down. Going to the shotgun. Got out of the base formation with fullback. Great coverage downfield.
Jason Brooks there on the rush of Travis Clark. And you see Kreit there just couldn't hang on. Well, that ball was right there.
Great read out of the quarterback.
It brings up third down and four. And I got to think just getting a first down here would be a big accomplishment, as Lincoln County is 2 of 7 of third down conversions today. And Clark will keep it, fakes the draw, doesn't even get to the 40-yard line, lucky to get back to the original line of scrimmage.
4:30 to go in the fourth quarter. You've got fourth down and four on your own 39-yard line. Coach Campbell's reaching deep into his bag of tricks. He's called a play. They've got to go for it here.
Well,
down
Clark,
by two.
Clark is also the punter on the team. That fake punt may come into play here.
Big, big, big call.
Stunned Lincoln County sideline. On fourth down and five, Clark will be out of shotgun. Retreats. Of Stephen Brown and makes a huge play for the Trion Bulldogs. And look at the Trion Bulldog fans.
170-pound junior, what a play. He made a little bit of a gamble going for the interception on fourth down. He could have batted it down, but he didn't want a chance that the ball would bat up and be a reception. He took the ball and took it to the ground. Great, smart, smart play by that cornerback. CB Chandler, the cornerback. See him here.
Well, last time Larry Campbell played this Trion team, 74, he was beat. And it's not looking good for him here. Down by two. And we're trying with an offensive possession. And we have a timeout on the field called by Trion.
Good, good call, good call. Got all his timeouts. Go ahead and use it. 3:58 to go in the fourth quarter. You're up by two. You got great field position. Let's let them calm down. Let the big guys rest. What a game these kids have played here in second half.
Of course, Trion's only loss this year was to a 4A school, Ringgold, in week two, 28-14. Won region 6A. 12-1 coming this game. And boy, they had all the momentum in the second half.
3-0. In the playoff season, everybody's coming in 3-0. Everybody's equal right now.
No first downs this half. Wow. For Lincoln County.
Number two offense in the state of Georgia.
Trion has 9 first downs. It's been an offensive show in the second half for the Trion Bulldogs. And they march up to the line. Brandon Hennon leading the way. First down and 10 at midfield. Going to blitz Lincoln County, but it's Chapman on the sweep. He's got room. Gets 10 yards, maybe 12.
And he stayed in bounds.
38-yard sideline. Yes, he stayed in bounds. Jarris Wynn and Stephen Brown there. Here's Chapman on the run.
Tall sweep. 49 sweep. They've stopped the clock, John. The first official down there rolled the clock, turned his arm. They're replacing the chain.
It's gone.
First down. Okay.
85 yards for Chris Chapman.
Wow.
And a touchdown. 2-point conversion.
90 for Day, 85 for him. What kind of balance? That is just unbelievable balance.
And,
how do you run it?
Blevins, too. That's their game. On first down, it's Blevins to the 35. Breaks the single tackle. Stephen Brown
tackle.
Brings him down to short of the 30.
Touchdown saving tackle from Brown.
And the offensive line of the Trion Bulldogs is wearing down this Lincoln County defense. Of course, they've been on the field a lot in the second half.
These are two unbelievably strong football teams. The leg strength, arm strength. These are two very, very, very good football teams. It's a shame that one of these teams is going to have to go home and the other one marches on.
You think Clarence Blevins is smiling right now, watching grandson Daniel in this atmosphere?
Oh, man. Clarence is a great guy. Started his career at Cherokee County High School.
Second and four.
Long time ago.
And it's Blevins, and he's stood up by Octavius Andrews at the line of scrimmage, maybe a yard.
And more importantly, John, is that clock keeps on grinding. Grind the clock.
Well, we're reaching the two-minute mark.
And Lincoln County has one timeout. They've had to burn their timeouts there in the third quarter, and they just don't have the opportunity to stop that clock.
268 rushing yards for Trion. 131 yards for Lincoln County.
2-1. 2-1. It's unbelievable. And all of this, John, has come the second half for the Bulldogs from Trion.
Third and three. Blevins loses the pitch but falls on it. And Trion will keep possession, but it'll bring up a fourth down and long.
Big, big, big decision here. You're going to punt it, chance a block punt, pin them deep in their territory, or go ahead and go for it.
They've got to think the way the Trion defense has played.
Punt.
Might want to punt.
Yeah, they've gone for it on fourth down all day and been successful. So let's see what they do. Maybe burn a timeout here and just let them rest.
We'll let that
go
clock
ahead and
run.
Do with it. Let that clock.
I've got to think. What did Mark Loudermilk say in that locker room?
Take the
boy. Have
here.
They,
let it. Yeah. Oh yes.
Have they responded?
And the Devils, Red Devils came out, Lincoln County came out and said, hey, fumble. First play of the second half.
And that just took all the wheels off the express, it seems like.
Yeah.
There's nothing that's gone right for Lincoln County.
Gave Trion, and here's
Larry
the timeout.
Campbell just doesn't know what to do.
Yeah, they let the clock run as long as they let it run. And did they take the delay of game? No, they did not. They called timeout just before the delay of game.
Mark Loudermilk, his second year as head coach, and there's Larry Campbell. 34 years at Lincoln County. 363 wins.
First state championship run as a head coach for Coach Loudermilk. And how poetic is it that the first time that Coach Campbell ran for the state championship in 1974 was against the same Trion High School with those bald heads, shaved heads from his Trion Bulldogs.
Trion won state championships in 57. And in 1974, Lincoln County, well, Larry Campbell has 9 state titles under his watch, the last coming in 1995.
Got 12 overall for the school, and they've played for it another half dozen times. So this is familiar territory, familiar altitude for these Lincoln County Red Devils.
Last time Lincoln County was at the Georgia Dome for the semifinals was in 2000, and they ran into a Commerce team that went on to defeat them.
Monte Williams,
exactly. Michael Collins, the quarterback. They were a duo. On fourth down, they're going for it. And they've been perfect so far on fourth down conversions. And it's always been a sweep to Chapman, but this time he's going to be caught and won't make it to the first down marker. Knocked out of bounds by Ronci Cummings.
Both teams are even on turnovers, John. 2 turnovers for both. So everything is evened up. 1:05, first down for Lincoln County. 1 minute to go in the fourth quarter to get the opportunity to go to state championship. Coach Loudermilk looks green. It may be because of pneumonia, and it may be because of stress.
Well, Josh Beard is a pretty decent field goal kicker, but they have to get pretty deep to get in his range, and it just takes a field goal to win it.
34 yards is his field goal this year.
Trion short flick, backs off. Clark going long and going for Brown. He's got it.
What a catch. What a catch.
Stephen Brown to the 25-yard line.
Oh, John.
And Lincoln County's got something to cheer about in the second half.
57 seconds.
Clark stopped as he moved the chains. And watch this throw by Travis Clark. 42 yards, and Stephen Brown makes a sensational catch.
And where Travis set his feet, it was right at 49 yards in the air.
First big play of the second half for Lincoln County on first down. And Clark will throw again. And he's looking for Brown, and he's got it. No, it's for Keno Mickens.
What a decision from Coach Campbell to go to the shotgun. Look at Travis Clark up there taking charge of the two-minute offense. He's going to ground the football. He's going to down it and stop the clock.
With one timeout left, that's what he does. With 30 seconds to go.
What a leader. What a smart kid. Savvy. Well coached.
Everybody on their feet at the Georgia Dome. This game has been something.
Coach Campbell's demeanor has changed drastically. Coach Campbell is in charge. He is large and in charge. These kids really respect him. The whole community loves him.
Well, he's a walking legend, Larry. He's won more games than any other high school football coach in Georgia. And here comes the Red Devils. They feel that maybe momentum is on their side now with 30 seconds to go. And Clark looking toward Brown.
Oh, what a pass.
Touchdown.
Oh, what a pass.
Larry.
25 seconds. The Bulldogs are devastated. What a pass. What a catch. It's his second touchdown reception of the game. Travis Clark's second touchdown pass. They have the will to win. They will not give up. They always find a way. Down to their fourth tailback in the season. They lost six of their starting football players during the season, and somebody else just stepped in and took charge.
And look at the Trion sideline.
Dead ball foul, unsportsmanlike on the offense. After the score, 15-yard penalty, try for point.
And celebration foul on Lincoln County.
Not only has this been a great football game, it's been well officiated. I can't get over how the officials have taken charge of this game and let the kids play and keep it in a great demeanor. Coach Larry Campbell, the winningest coach in the state of Georgia. 360, on the verge of 365, John. See Coach Hatcher there, special teams coach. Coaching staff is outstanding. Both teams have outstanding coaching staffs. This Lincoln County coaching staff been together for years.
Well, Coach Campbell's seen it all as you take a look at the scoring drive. Four plays, 67 yards. The pass to Stephen Brown, 17 yards. Lincoln County's got the lead back, and they're going to go for two. And with the penalty, they'll start at the 17-yard line. No timeout to remain for Lincoln County. One left for the Bulldogs. And the Bulldog fans dressed in blue are stunned.
Yeah.
While the Lincoln County fans dressed in their red are back up.
That extra point would have been 37 yards. His field goal for the season is 34 out of his range.
Clark went for the end zone for two. And caught, but out of bounds.
Oh, what a catch.
Drumlong caught it, but he was out of bounds. And so our score will stay 28-24. Lincoln County with 25 seconds to go.
Drumlong made a great catch. Just unfortunately out of bounds. That's a highlight right there. 6'1", 210 pounds. Big Drumlong.
Now, we're going to take a look at the touchdown pass.
You see that cannon.
That was a cannon. Stephen Brown with an excellent catch.
Now, frozen rope.
If you're trying, you've been running all day. Now you're kind of in a situation where you're forced to throw long.
Well, the California kickoff return comes to mind, John. Or they have they got the old lateral play in and lateral this thing around. 25 seconds. You need to gamble right now on this. You don't have time. Got one timeout to play with. They're going to have to run and see if they've got it in. The California kickoff return where you keep lateraling and running across the field and try to get a seam. Trion's got speed to do it, John.
Josh Beard will kick it off. Corey Barnes and Chris Chapman back deep.
4-point lead. They've got to kick it deep.
I've got to think for Trion, they're going to have to put it up a few times. And Hennon has got the skills to do it. Allgood and Abernathy are both good receivers. And not the fastest guys in the world, but they can run routes well. And this is where they're going to have to step it up. And Chapman will take the kickoff at the 11.
Middle return.
Slips a little bit. And only gets to the 20-yard line. And we're down to 19 seconds. C.J. Norman on the stop for Lincoln County.
What a drive. What a football game, John. It's two games and 1 minute in the fourth quarter for Lincoln County to come back and regain a little momentum. It's just been unbelievable. What a start to the weekend. This is wall-to-wall football, Friday and Saturday, 30 hours.
And this is just the first of 10 games here on GPTV. You'll get your football fix this weekend.
The winner of this game will travel to the winner of tomorrow's game. So whether it be Clinch County or Hawkinsville, the state championship game will be there.
Hennon, being rushed, lets it go, looking for Barnes. Makino Mickens was there along with Ronci Cummings as Barnes had broken off his route. Coming up after this one, Vidalia and Charlton County in the 2A semifinal. We're looking at a 12-12 kickoff in that one. So stay tuned for that one. You fans from Vidalia and Charlton County and throughout the state of Georgia, we'll get that to you.
Last week, this Lincoln County team faced Metter. Zach Stanford, their all-state quarterback, just a junior, picked him off twice. So they're used to seeing the football in the air. Did a great job last week to shut down Metter.
12 seconds left. He trips right, one receiver to the left, and he'll throw a screen to Blevins.
Blevins out of bounds.
To the 30, and to the 34. Brown caused the fumble, 2 seconds left. They'll move the chain to the first down. Larry Campbell says, move that clock. And Lincoln County player is down.
Blevins is slow to get up himself.
Trion had one timeout left. And they'll use it right here. Larry Campbell is hollering at the officials to keep that clock running after Blevins was down. But the clock does stop after a first down.
Yes, exactly. And then Trion was smart to call the timeout right there. One more play, coach.
Well, you can't say enough about the effort of the Trion Bulldogs in the second half. They're down by 22 to nothing. They come back to score 24 unanswered points. Feeling great, and then Lincoln County strikes. And when you're a tremendous football program like Lincoln County, those good things happen to you.
Travis Clark, quarterback, what a game he's had. Octavius Andrews going both ways. Outstanding football players. Stephen Brown, 2 touchdown receptions in the game, playing defense, going both ways. Injuries decimated this Lincoln County team, and Coach Campbell and his staff found a way. These kids, what a heart.
2 seconds, last play of the game. Hennon.
Oh,
to Chapman. Chapman to the 20, still on his feet. Flag down. It won't matter.
Quarterback
as
was Hennon
was beyond the line of scrimmage. Lincoln County will advance to the state finals, 28-24. over the Trion Bulldogs. What a game. And what a comeback by Lincoln County. After Trion had scored 24 unanswered points, they come back late in the fourth quarter and win it. And we'll be right back after this. Welcome back to the Georgia Dome. Lincoln County advances the state finals, and Jared Oliveri is standing by with a happy Larry Campbell.
Coach, what a great game out there. Could you talk about it for a little bit?
Well, not right now. My heart's still beating too quick. Luck has something to do with out coming alive in a football game, and we got lucky. We got completely outplayed in the second half. We did not have a running back healthy. As most of you know, we had three tailbacks with ACLs torn. We didn't have a running back in the second half. The one kid we have was number 10, and he was cramping at half, and we just had to, we just struggled, and just like it's been all year, a different person comes up with a big play. I don't have the answer for it.
Congratulations, Coach, and good luck in the finals.
Thank you, Gerald. Lincoln County advances. We got much more coming up on GPTV for our crew here on the single A game. For Larry Prather, Jerry Oliveri, I'm John Wilkerson, saying so long.